morning and welcome to worship on this first Sunday of Advent. We are in a mostly empty sanctuary this morning. We have made the decision to use this Sunday particularly as a buffer Sunday after people perhaps gathering for Thanksgiving holidays together. We wanted to make sure that we gave ourselves a bit of space. And then on Wednesday, a group will be meeting to look at how much numbers have spiked in Illinois County to decide going forward what will be best for this congregation. So we will get word to you sometime after Wednesday of what our plans are. I want to welcome this morning Leah, who is playing for us. Phil is off this week. We have an angel tree up, and many of you took names off of the angel tree last Sunday. But we have six, I think, left. Yes, there are six names still on the angel tree, and I just wanted to let you know you have an opportunity to come by the church any day, Monday through Friday, 9 to 1. You might be wanting to bring gifts that you've already purchased for the person you pulled off of the angel tree. And if so, we are going to gather those gifts into the chapel, and you can just drop them off. Or perhaps you haven't had an opportunity to pick up an angel's name, and you would like to do that. Again, come by the church anytime, Monday through Friday, 9 to 1, and you can pick one up. Thank you so much to all of those of you who are helping with this project. I want to say thank you to Judy and Lisa and Cindy and Valerie and any others who might have been in on the decorating for this Sunday's beginning of the Advent season. It's a lot of work. And people were here late yesterday afternoon still putting final touches. I want to draw your attention to the communion table. You see that we have a stable on the communion table and not much else in the way of a holy family or shepherds or angels or wise men or any of those people. And that's because week by week we will be adding pieces to the stable as we tell the story of those who gathered there that long ago sacred night. So to begin this Sunday, Brad is going to put the wise men up, but they're not going to be at the manger. You know from the story, they traveled from afar. They come from the far east. And I don't know if that's the east side of sanctuary or not. That doesn't matter. For right now, in this scenario, that's east. And the wise men will slowly, week by week, make their way closer and closer to Bethlehem. So we will be moving them as is appropriate. If you got your bulletin ahead of time, you will know that there is a congregational introit. We are going to teach that to you today. When we get to that part in the service, Leah will play it one time through and I'll sing it. And then I'm hoping that you will feel comfortable enough joining in and you'll sing along with us at home. Those of you who are here in the sanctuary can join in as well. And in that way, we will begin this week-to-week congregational introit that we will use for the whole season. Pastoral concerns that I want to share with you this morning. We got word this midweek, I guess, DY has tested positive for COVID, so lots of concerns there. You're going to notice in a little while as the Advent wreath is lit, that it is not Dane and Kristen who are with us this morning. They were with DY some this past week, so they are self-quarantined for 2 weeks, and Dawn and Marilyn Smith have graciously agreed to fill in for them. Last Sunday, we had gotten word that Kay Smith has also tested positive for COVID. So please hold both DY and Kay in your prayers and their families, who's, of course, worried for their safety and their health. We also got word that Bonnie Hampton wasn't in church last Sunday because she has pinched a nerve in her back. She's been to the doctor. She is in lots and lots of pain, taking different medicines that don't seem to be working quite well. And her plan is to try and see the doctor again this week sometime. I think that's all of the announcements and pastoral concerns to share with you this morning. Brad, I think we are ready for the lighting of the Christ candle. Remember you are baptized and be thankful.
Today we begin the journey of Advent with the world shrouded in fear and anxiety. The darkness of the unknown future surrounds us.
Right now, we are experiencing lost hopes, not only for this holiday season, but for our lives. But we gather around this wreath each week to be reminded that God's light has come into the world, and nothing can overcome it. We light the candle of hope, trusting God's promise that Christ can fill our lives and the world with new life.
Let us pray. Even in the midst of fear, of challenge, of struggle, we give thanks, Holy One, that we have hope in you, even when our view is obscured by the clouds of doubt. We trust, Holy One, that you can light the flame of hope within us. Amen.
Now is when we're going to learn this congregational introit.
Thank you. rise for the call to worship. We come struggling to be bearers of hope in a troubled and fearful world.
May Christ come down, come in, come among us, entering our darkness with his light.
We come watching and waiting, praying and preparing for Christ's advent among us.
May Christ come down, come in, come among us, entering our darkness with his light.
And we'll now sing, Come Thou Long Expected Jesus. To receive the Christ child is to repent and to be faithful. Let us confess our sins and by doing so open ourselves to God. Join me now. Gracious God, the darkness in us deepens, awaiting your light. The hope in us falters, longing for your promise. Forgive us for letting doubt and fear take hold in our lives. Renew our trust in your light to shine in the darkness of our lives. In spite of all that is wrong in us and in the world, help us to hold on to hope in you. Church offices are open. Thank you. join me with the prayer for illumination. Compassionate God, since faith comes by hearing your word, help us to listen to the scriptures with all attention, that they may criticize our faults, confirm our faith, and console our spirits. Through Jesus Christ, the Word made flesh. Amen.
Amen.
This morning's scripture, we start with Mark 13, 24 through 26. And this piece of scripture says, as an introduction, Mark calls the people to watch for the coming of Christ. He reassures his readers that the time will come when Christ will come again. The early church was encouraged by believing that God saw their suffering and would act to end it. They held on to that hope and waited, not with anxiety, but with certainty. Mark. But in those days, after that suffering, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be falling from heaven, and the powers in heaven will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with great glory and power.
Our second reading is from the book of Isaiah, chapter 40, verses 9 through 11. Isaiah writes to a people in exile who sit in a time of darkness that seems unending, and yet he tells the people to look for good tidings are here. He tells them not to fear, for the Lord God comes to care for his people. Listen for God's holy word. Get you up to a high mountain, O Zion, herald of good tidings. Lift up your voice with strength, O Jerusalem, herald of good tidings. Lift it up. Do not fear. Say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. See, the Lord God comes with might, and his arm rules for him. His reward is with him, and his recompense before him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms and carry them in his bosom and gently lead the mother sheep. This is the word of the Lord, the word of life.
Thanks be to God.
With this first Sunday of Advent, we mark the beginning of a new liturgical year. It is a time of waiting and expectation, a time of preparation and anticipation, as we mark once again the birth of Jesus. The preacher Fleming Rutledge says that Advent begins in darkness. That's certainly true in this text from Mark. The sun will be darkened and the moon will not give its light. The stars will be falling from heaven. In Mark, there is no babe lying in a manger with Mary and Joseph and the cattle gathered around. No, with Mark, we begin the first Sunday of a new church year with the stars falling from heaven. We begin in darkness. Somehow that seems appropriate for 2020 to me. Does it to you? My world is a bit darker because I see such anger and meanness in the world. Stars seem to have fallen because people that I love and admired have died with the coronavirus. Where is the light? We're tired of wearing masks. We're tired of keeping those we love at arm's length. We are anxious and afraid, trying to be cautious. We're mentally fatigued and soul weary at the state that the world is in. Darkness seems to have descended upon us with this virus that continues to wreak havoc with our plans, with our lives. Maybe it's just me. Maybe it's from carrying this passage from Mark around in my head this past week But since changing from daylight savings time, I'm very aware of how early the darkness descends each day. And as I work with people and hear their stories, I'm aware that sometimes darkness is just a metaphor for all the hurt and pain that people carry in their lives. All the lights in the house can be blazing, and yet we sit in the darkness of anxiety or depression. The darkness of a long winter night can become the darkness of the soul. Maybe you've known some of that kind of darkness when there's an empty chair at your table, or you've gotten a recent diagnosis of illness, when there is not enough money to pay the bills, let alone buy Christmas presents, when a marriage is ending, when downsizing means your job is about to end, when the best medicines can't seem to make things better, when depression shows up like an unwanted guest, when nothing seems to be going right and the world is out of whack. During times of darkness, the dawn of a new day seems ever so long away, and it is hard to find any light shining in the darkness. Hear these words of the poet Anne Leans, who was a Presbyterian, by the way. Into the silent night, as we make our weary way, we know not where. Just when the night becomes its darkest, and we cannot see our path, just then is when angels rush in, their hands full of stars. Advent might begin in darkness, but its message is that hope, like a candle that dispels the darkness, awaits us. Advent reminds us that the light has already come. Advent declares that even in the darkest night, a light already shines. In the birth of the Christ child during the stillness of the night, a light has come into the world with the power to dispel the darkness. And so we hope in the light. We hope in the promise that God's love triumphs over the power of hopelessness and fear. We hope in the promise that God has broken into our world and nothing is the same as it was. Each week, we light the Advent candles and proclaim that God is present with us, even in the darkness. We celebrate that God lights our path, guides our feet, and invites us to set aside our fears. I'm not sure if you remember, there was a radio ad that was popular several years back that had Tom Baudet promising weary travelers, "We'll leave the light on for you." Well, there is a Moravian Christmas custom that comes from an old story that on Christmas Eve, the Christ child carries bundles of evergreens and wanders all over the world. Those who long for his coming set a lighted candle in the window to welcome him, him into their homes and into their hearts. Each candle is a small light shining in the darkness. Each welcomes God in Christ to find a home in us. My weekly luminaria devotions will ask you to light a candle each Sunday Moravian tradition. We hope in the light, this light of Christ who has promised to come again. In hope, we watch and wait and prepare. In hope, we invite Christ to come to us once again, to illuminate our darkness, to create a space within us for insight and vision, for calm, assurance, and peace. In hope, we yearn for Messiah to come again, to surprise us with light and life, to gift us with peace. But Advent is more than just waiting for the darkness to end. It is also about helping to overcome that darkness. As children of light, we share in the light and we bear the light everywhere we go, by what we say and what we do and how we live. We are not the first to experience a time of deep darkness like coronavirus had brought to us, and we will not be the last. But in this moment, in our time, we have choices to make about whether we will be overcome by the darkness around us, or if we will raise our voices to proclaim another way, to proclaim a belief that we can participate and bringing more light into the world, because our hope is in Christ, who is the light of the world. Advent recognizes that there is something incomplete in our lives, in our world, and it voices a longing and a trust that God will come and transform us, that God will come and shine a light into our darkest nights. The word Advent means coming, the coming of God into our lives. How will we prepare for Christ's coming this year, this season, this day? This year, in the midst of fear and anxiety and stress, we need to hear a word of comfort. This year, in the midst of weariness and disillusionment and worry, we need to hear a word of hope. Fear not, the angels so often proclaim as they bring messages from God. For this first Sunday of Advent, I imagine the message of the angel might be, fear not, for there is hope for tomorrow. Isaiah the prophet and Mark the gospel writer reassure the people that good news is already beginning. Mark says that even in the worst of times, when it seems like the world is coming to an end, we will see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with great power and glory. Isaiah tells the people not to lose heart, not to fear. They should lift up their voices and sing, because God will come with might and he will tend to his flock. On this first Sunday of Advent, can we believe that there is hope for tomorrow? Can we hold on to the hope that God is at work in the world in ways that we do not see and cannot understand? Please join me in prayer as this sermon comes to an end. God of hope, we come to you in the darkness and uncertainty of our lives. We pray that you would transform our doubt, heal our brokenness, strengthen our weakness. For you are faithful.
the long-expected Savior, came into the world as a child, descended from David, conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of Mary, a virgin. We believe that Jesus was born of woman as a very child, yet was born of God's power as was no other child. Through his birth, life, death, and resurrection, Jesus brings about the relationship between God and humanity that God always intended.
This we believe. Join me now in prayer. Almighty God, we give thanks that you have come to us in creation with the gift of life. You give us the earth and all its days and seasons, for all the abundance of Thanksgiving feasts and family traditions. We give you thanks. You have come in Jesus Christ with the gift of salvation. We give you praise for the hope of the world that came to Bethlehem and for the promise that Christ will come again. You bring good news for our despair, grace for our sin, and light for our darkness. Help us, O God, to watch for the signs of your reign. Open our eyes to behold your presence in all parts of our lives. Keep us from putting you on the fringe of existence, from turning to you only when we are in need. Lord, I give you thanks for this worshiping community, for all they do to make a difference in the world, to shed your light in the world, for foods collected and the people that they will nourish, we give you thanks. For those who are preparing for the angels from the angel tree, we give you thanks. Continue to show us ways that our lives might shine your hope into the world. During this Advent season, keep us awake and alert, O God, watching for your coming kingdom, waiting for your light. Instill your hope deep within our hearts. Prepare us to hear again the song of the angels and see again the light of the beckoning star. For us who hunger and thirst for your presence, come. Come and be with us and among us. Hear us now as with one voice we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
this